only a student of history and have read histories of many civilizations. And one thing I have found common across the civilization, and that is there are two sets of people who hold the sanctity of civilization. The first set of people are saints. They are responsible for spiritual freedom. And the second set is of saints, who are accountable for our geographical freedom. Under this hall, we have got both of them. The name of the saint is Acharya Sachidananda Bharti, alias Air Force Baba. This is for the benefit of freshers, because Swamiji had been to our college a couple of times. I'll just give a brief description about him. He was a squadron leader of the Indian Air Force, which he quit after an encounter with death in an air accident in 1982. Now he is a promoter of peace and sustainable development. He is also the founder and Acharya Guru of Yagarjuna Shanti Mission, the leader of Mission Shanti Sansad, and has authored many books. I request Professor Rita, director of PMC department, to welcome Swamiji with a memento. In welcoming Swamiji with a huge round of applause. Thank you, ma'am.
The newly elected council required to take an oath before assuming their position as council and cabinet members. They take the oath to shoulder the responsibility as leaders and to carry out the duties in fidelity and loyalty towards the welfare of their classmates and the college. I am happy to present before you the new team of cabinet and council members. Friends, put your hands together and welcome the new team. Dear students, as they take the oath, I request you to maintain absolute silence. This is a solemn occasion. I request you stretch out your right hand. Please repeat the oath after me.
Struggle, not a political struggle,
control. Truth is a very rare commodity. Those who speak for truth and those who stand for truth will have to suffer. And my friends, the history of the world, the history of humanity is written by a handful of people who have the courage of character and strength of character to bear witness to truth and pay the price. And man, as I said, if you look into the history, you will find those who have begun something new, the new thinkers, the philosophers, the innovators, the inventors, all had to pay a price. And the price was ridicule, the price was suffering, the price was rejection. When the Wright brothers thought about flying the first plane, people ridiculed them, saying that they must be out of their mind. Because flying is meant for birds, not for human beings. And when Galileo, John Kepler, all the great scientists brought in their discoveries, the world laughed at them. The religious people, in a way, persecuted them. But they stood their ground and won at the end. My dear friends, this is what you are doing. Your college has a dream. Your college has a mission, which is carried forward by each one of you when you go out from the borders of this college, from this college. You have to work on that. This year, 2017, is the centenary year of the Champaran Satyagraha, the first non-violent campaign of Mahatma Gandhi in the freedom struggle of India, which has remained the largest, the greatest non-violent contribution in human history. So that campaign, started by the Mahatma in 1917 from Champaran, Bihar, today we need to start a new campaign. That was the first freedom struggle, and today we need a second freedom struggle. Gandhiji, just 3 days before his death, he said, "Congress has won political freedom, but India is yet to win economic freedom, social freedom, moral freedom. Three more freedoms: economic, social, and moral. Economic, because 30% of the Indians are living below poverty line even today. We don't speak about those people who struggle hard to meet their ends. Development in the market economy is determined by the gross national product. That means the rich and the powerful, if they multiply their gross, the GDP has increased. Some of you may remember years ago there was a tsunami. Thousands of people died. Crores and crores of rupees were lost. But there was no ripple in the stock market of Bombay. There was no ripple in the market economy. The market was not touched. But when there was a difference of opinion between the Ambani brothers, the Bombay stock had changed then. When there was a difference of opinion, the Tata management, the stock exchange fell. So my young friends, we must understand the market economy and the stock exchange all to do with the rich and the powerful. The poor and the hungry millions have no say in it. Development, as Gandhi understood, is to be measured in terms of the last and the least. And his talisman, he said, when he made a decision, recollect the faces of poorest man you have seen and imagine in what way your decision is going to make a difference in the life of this man. That is Gandhi's talisman. of the condition of that family. Look at the face of children in the country, you can take out the development of the country. Sustainable development, true development, begins with the children. The happy and healthy childhood for every child in this country. So this second freedom struggle has to begin with a campaign for healthy and happy childhood. And that is what brings me back to Bihar again. Because this land is a holy land. This land has given birth to many things, inspiring history. This land is not.